Now, please welcome to the stage the Vice President of the United States of America, Mike Pence.
Water, my favorite drink. Plain, pure water. Beautiful. So let's start, just the two of us, or?
Actually, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, right, of course.
The President of the United States of America, Donald Trump.
No, we have to get up again, though. I don't think we can do the whole thing lying down. There you go. There we go. That's what you said about being president. I told you you have to stand up for that. So.
I don't want that water.
So wonderful. This is not the president you're looking for. Not the president anyone's looking for.
Are you having a hard time with your chair, sir?
No, I'm fine, Mike. Stand up, Mike. Stand up. Mike Pence, everybody.
Thank you so much.
Mike Pence, so great. What a great leader. Mike, were you sitting on that? You weren't raised up at all.
It was on the side, sir. Hiding it.
Sure, Mike.
So, Mr.
Mike likes butt stuff.
No. That's not true. I mean, it's a little true, but it's not, you know.
It's a little true.
So, Mr. President, you are here at Comic-Con?
Mm-hmm. I am. I thought that this... Excuse me.
I think an elf is yelling at you, sir.
An elf's yelling at me? Link? Who's Link?
Oh, Link.
Link, you've got a hit franchise right now. You're back like nobody's business on the Switch. We all know it. You're bigger than Skyrim. You're better than Skyrim. We love you, Link. We love you. This is my crowd.
It is actually Comic-Con, and as you can see, there are some superheroes and comic book characters. Do you have a favorite?
A favorite what? Superhero?
Yeah.
I was going to say I have a favorite con. See, I thought this was a convention for other con artists who have pulled over some of the greatest cons, like the Brinks heist to that Don Draper guy who jumped out of the plane.
I don't think his name was Don Draper.
Don Draper jumped out of a plane. That's what happened. Then he landed in the ad agency, and they said, you're hired. I don't need help. And then, of course, I'm the greatest con artist, and I figured that's why I was the keynote speaker. But I love superheroes. There are great superheroes every day, okay? Great superheroes. But when we talk about a superhero, they've got to be super, and that criteria means that they're great, they're the best. So, hello. And they got to be a hero, and there's one great hero, and it's me. I'm the head of the military, I'm a super soldier. As the head of the military, you're the greatest soldier that's ever lived, because you got elected president. So I am a machine gun man. I'm a machine gun mama. So I would say me, I'm my greatest superhero, okay? I'm the greatest superhero ever. And if I had to say fictional superhero, I would absolutely say Ant-Man.
Ant-Man.
Ant-Man. Ant-Man. Tiny guy. Big problems.
Jesus. I wasn't, I don't have biblical Tourette's. I was answering your question.
I presume. Jesus and Ant-Man.
I'd like to see them do battle. That would be...
Wow. That's right. Ant-Man, he could fly around with the pegs and spike Jesus really fast on the cross. It happened, folks. It happened.
It is true.
Jesus got nailed up to the cross.
It is not, it's not
too
soon.
That's not fake news.
Not too soon.
It's not too soon. It's too late.
You know what, though? If Andrew Jackson was president, he would have stopped it.
That's right. It's very true. We talk about this all the time. If Andrew Jackson had been alive when Jesus was around, if he had just lived long enough...
He would have stopped.
He would have gone. He would have said to Pontius Pilate. He would have said, first off, why is your nickname Pilate?
Yes.
There's no planes in Rome at the time.
Planes.
And what a rude first nickname. Just because you got a little punch.
Mm-hmm. Pontius.
Pontius.
Fupa Pilate was his
Fupa name. Pilate.
So, Mr. President, I think one of the things that folks would like to know here in the room is, how do you find the time to host a late night talk show while also, you know, running the country?
There's plenty of time, Sam, okay? You and the fake news media make it seem like it's so difficult to be the president, and it's not at all, okay? So easy. First off, I go to bed at 3:30 at night. I always make sure to stay up and watch a rerun of McHale's Navy on MeTV. And if I'm really excited, I watch Comics Come Alive, or whatever that show is. We have four comics who talk to another guy.
Byron Allen.
Byron Allen.
Comics
the funniest guy in comedy, Byron Allen. And then I go to bed, I sweat, I wake up, I have visions of my mother hiding in the bed. I usually travel to other places and spaces, dimensions beyond time and space. Then I wake up at 3:35. Right to the toilet, because I gotta spray that thing. And they have special toilet. I have a half toilet urinal. So I sort of back into it and just spray. And I start tweeting
like
around 4 in the morning, and then I'm tweeting till 7. Then it's time to go eat, and I have 2 Twinkies. I have a deep-fried bowl of Special K. We fry the whole bowl. It makes it crunchy. You can eat it. And then I got to see Mike, and Mike shows up, and he's like, sir, we got to do work. And I'm like, shut up, Mike.
That takes about 2 hours.
Yeah.
A lot of screaming.
Just screaming, shut up! Shut up for about 2 hours. Yep. And then when my throat starts spitting blood, it's time for lunch. And then I always say, why can't we get human meat? I'm the president. Shouldn't we be able to eat human meat? If you're the president, boo yourself. Go get him out. Get him out of here. Get him out of here. Get him out of here. I'll tell you right now, I will pay any Santarans in the room. If there are Santarans here, there's 50 bucks in it, rough them up.
I don't know what that is.
Santarans are a race that have no moral boundaries. Mm. They'll flip on a dime. They're like little dome people. They look like a little titty with no nipple. That's what their
I
head
feel like
looks
a nipple
like.
Is one of the most defining parts of the breast. So.
That's exactly right.
Oh. interesting.
And then I do, and then we prepare for the show. The writers and the staff, all the great people who do the president show, I don't look at any of the material. Then I go, I read what it says off the prompter, just like everything else I do. And I don't even digest it. I don't even know what I'm saying. And then it's over. And I look at Mike, I scream shut up at him for another two hours. And then it's time to go to bed to kick Melania out of the room and get some sleep. Thank you.
Okay. Well, we've got to ask. I mean, the show is going on, and in the
it is. We got to get out of here, Mike.
Oh, no,
I meant it's
in the long term.
It's happening.
It's happening.
Fake news.
Well, I mean, one of the questions I think that everybody has on their mind is what will happen to the show in the event that you are, say, impeached.
What? Excuse me. Excuse me. Excuse me. What I would love, excuse, Mike. Mike, no one's ever responded to you like this. What are you doing?
Nothing. I was just, I passed some wind and I was just blowing it.
That's fine. It's healthier when you smell your own gas. Now, that's true. It's a cancer preventative. That's a real story. Go Google farts prevent cancer. It'll change your life.
But you will get a lot of interesting pop-up ads.
Oh, yeah.
If you Google farts.
And prevent some pop-up ads and some dribble out ads. Anyway, excuse me, get him out. Let me tell you this. There'll be no impeachment. Mueller. Okay, first off, they've got a guy named Mueller, so he's mulling everything.
Robert Mueller.
Mueller. Mueller's mulling, and he's mulling all the time. I wish he was muddling. And if he was muddling, then we'd have some great mojitos, wouldn't we? But we just have mulling.
He's the special counsel.
You don't need to say that. He might be the special counsel, but he can do anything a regular counsel can do. I find that very offensive. And we call him around the White House, differently counsel. Mm. Differently counsel.
Famously respectful of the disabled.
What? Oh, so much.
Very
so
respectful
much.
Of disabled.
So much. And what we're gonna do, I'm gonna fire Mueller, and I'm gonna get Comey back in.
Comey.
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 I've only heard it.
Listen, Comey was all over the place. I had to fire him because Comey was up my ass.
No.
And he was coming hard.
No.
And this is what you signed up for, right? And so we're gonna get Comey back in, okay? Because everyone loves a reboot, okay? Right? We love reboots. And so we need to bring him back. We're gonna bring Comey back. We have a different guy play Comey, okay? More muscular. It'll be a darker palette, okay? Everyone knows when you do a reboot, it's gotta get darker, right? It's always gotta be darker. There's no such thing as a reboot where it's just more of the same fun. It's gotta be dark and depressing. Just ask the DC Universe. And burn, total burn. I'm a Marvel guy. I'm a Marvel guy. And I'm not afraid to admit it. Anyway, that's what we're going to do at the end.
Okay.
What do you want?
Oh, nothing.
President Trump, if you don't mind, I'd like to turn to some of the issues that are facing us now.
No.
Well, then let's talk about immigration. Why have you taken such a strong stance against immigration?
They're bringing so many terrible people here. They're not sending their best. But this all started because of a documentary I saw in 1980 about a man who came from another planet called Krypton. He lands here, no papers, and a hard-working, white, middle-class family takes him in. And what does this guy do? What does he do? subterfuge, deception, lying. He takes that Lana, and he wants to steal Lana away from her beautiful boyfriend. And he races the train, and he runs faster than the train.
Are you talking about the first Superman, sir?
I'm talking about a documentary I saw. It was so old, Gene Hackman had hair. Mm-hmm. And
Gene Hackman isn't everything.
Gene Hackman, oh, yeah.
In all
documentaries. Well, Hoosiers. Hoosiers. Love Hoosiers.
I love Hoosiers so much.
For Greg. He prays to Hoosiers. So anyway, we need to stop illegal aliens, real aliens, from coming to this planet. And so I want to start with the aliens here as a preparation for when the real aliens show up. Because we got to build that space wall.
I'm sorry, did you say illegal aliens?
Illegal aliens. Illegal aliens. They've got to come here legally. Legally. Then this guy, he comes up with a secret identity. That's deceptive. Then he stares at Lois Lane through her dress, which is a violation. So much that she had to wear a lead dress so he wouldn't look at her. And then he destroys Metropolis. And this is what aliens can do to us. It's all a roadmap right there. So we need to get rid of them, starting with the Man of Steel. What's that? Cool.
But I guess, I mean, just leaving real aliens out of it for a moment, the Dreamers, for instance. I mean, what do you say to those whose fate remains in limbo, like these children of...
DACA.
DACA, that's correct.
DACA.
We worked on this before. I would say the program, and then we had flashcards. Because he was saying caca so often, so I had to
caca.
Write it out and make sure that he said DACA.
DACA.
DACA, with a D.
DACA, these are people who were born here, okay? First off, let me tell you something. These people, their parents come to this country, they show up to the border, they put the woman right on the border, she births the baby in the United States, they clip the cord, and then it becomes a citizen. Totally unfair. So what I want to do is repeal all citizenship. I'll tell you how you solve DACA. You solve DACA by making it all caca. Everyone loses their citizenship, and we're going to create a Rite Aid-style Dwayne Reed rewards program. And what you do is you purchase products from Trump Torture Center and casinos, which we're currently building.
Currently building.
They're going to be so incredible. We'll torture dissidents, and at the same time, it's a full gambling casino. It's unbelievable. And...
Video blackjack.
Video blackjack. And live blackjack, where people sit at a table, a guy runs up with an old-fashioned blackjack, and you bet on who they're gonna hit in the head. And craps, where you take a dissident and feed them pages from the Quran until they go to the bathroom.
My
which
idea.
Which is something this country really did. Don't know that? You should look that up, because that's real. Right, Sam?
That's real, yeah.
Thank you, Sam. Fake news. Then you earn points based on how we value citizens of this country. So if you're a guy, boy, you get 1,000 points right away. That's it. Because we know that, or else we would have a female president if we cared at all about people equally. Because there's no way at all that I would have been elected if America and the world didn't hate women so much. Some hard truths, folks. Some hard truths.
I'm not a fan.
Not a fan.
Not a fan.
Mike?
I like one women. Woman, and I like her so much that she's my wife and my mother.
So hot.
So.
That's some crazy Christian shit right there, right? Crazy Christian shit.
Crazy.
So crazy.
I'm a little crazy.
And then everyone gets their points rewards, and you get deported if you don't, and you get discounts on all like toothpastes and mouthwash, all kinds of great stuff.
Okay.
Coming soon to a country near you.
We worked on that. We worked on that. Coming soon to a country that's Mike's party says that. I go, DACA! Coming soon.
Do it.
It was announced today that your nominee for the number two at the EPA is a former coal executive.
Yeah, cool guy.
Coal.
Coal.
Why?
Clean coal.
Clean.
Clean it up.
Are you saying to clean up coal?
Clean up the coal. Clean the coal, make it clean, and then burn it.
Coal so clean you could wash a baby with it.
That's right. That's what we want. Take a baby, lower it into a pile of coal, roll it around, take it out.
Burn the coal after you remove the baby.
We learned the hard way during the testing. Burned a lot of babies. The babies. The babies. The babies. When the baby, if I just see a baby get hurt, I fire 59 missiles somewhere in the world. That's what I do.
Well, I guess the question is, why such enthusiasm for coal and for fossil fuel in general at a time when we're facing climate change?
Coal, first off, coal is clean. It's wonderful. We've added thousands, tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands, a million coal jobs. Just in the time that I've been saying it, we've added a million jobs. Watch this. 2 million jobs. There's 2 million coal jobs. That's how it works.
I don't.
Coal, get them out. Coal. Coal is like wishes. If you wish for coal, it's there. All you have to do is say there's tons of coal jobs. It doesn't matter that there's only 32,000 in the United States. But if you think there's 2 million, then there are. You have to believe, Sam. You gotta believe. You gotta put your heels together, click three times, and go, there's no place like coal. There's no job like coal. There's no job like coal. Get it? From the Wizard of Oz. Look at all the work we get done in the Oval Office. And that's just one day. I mean, that's like 5 minutes.
Steve is not with us anymore, but I do sometimes walk into the Oval at night, and the president is chanting.
That's right.
He's chanting an incantation, and he's has a bunch of candles lit up, and he's wearing a long, dark, hooded robe. And he's...
Steve told me that's how to summon him.
Yeah.
You have to draw a five-pointed star in your own blood, surround it with salt, chant the proper incantation, he will manifest to you.
Exactly, his name over and over again. So sometimes he's there, sometimes he pops in, and then I throw holy water on him and he fizzles away. And it's a game, it's fun, you know, we have a good time.
We love Steve. I want to get back to the environment.
Really?
Yes. It's so important to me to tell you this. Everyone talks about coal, and everyone talks about green energy. And there's so much green energy. Everybody loves green energy, right? Who loves the green energy? Green energy, green this, green that. But I met with an incredible guy, this guy during the campaign, who funded so much of what I did. And he taught me about a new power source, a limitless power source in the United States. He's a British Duke named David. We had a great meeting. We had to go way out into the woods. They burned a beautiful tea for me for Trump. It was just incredible. And this energy source is very powerful because they had to wear all these hoods to prevent, I guess, radiation. I don't really get it. It's science. And they understand it better than me. And they taught me about an unlimited power that has been running the United States, and let's say the world, for hundreds and hundreds of years, called white power. White power. It ran my campaign. It runs the United States. It runs the Western world. And it's everywhere. White power's right here. White power's everywhere. And it's unlimited. So move over coal and oil. Because down with black power and up with white power. Make a pledge with me. Make a pledge. Make a pledge with me right now. You don't like that? Good. You passed the test.
And I know With me, I know all about this, and I don't say anything.
So, that's great. Mike always stays silent. He always stays silent, but he quietly supports it, like most of the Republican Party.
Speaking of the Republican Party's agenda, at this point, I mean, can you say whether or not you will ever repeal and replace Obamacare?
Repeal and replace.
Yes.
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 Repeal and replace. And replace.
We will say it all the time.
Yes. Repeal and replace.
It's actually harder to say. It's more challenging to say than it is to actually do. I think it takes more guts to say it than it does to do it.
Yeah, so. That's true. Mike's so right. Why do it when you can just say it? Yeah. That's the motto of the Trump administration. You know, we're working on it. We're chiseling away at women's rights right now. That's where we're working.
I'm holding that chisel.
That's right. Today, we just announced that women who work for crazy Christian employers, like Mike, Mike's a crazy Christian, who say women can't have birth control, then they can't have it. So we've decided, instead of trying to legislate it, we're going to reverse every executive order that Obama made and take it away. And then what we'll do is we'll repeal and replace. And if we can't do that, get ready for it. We'll reveal and bait race. So we always have that in our back pocket. We can always reveal ourselves and bait race if we can't repeal and replace. I got a doctor. What's the big deal?
Last night, Mr.
It's ugly, isn't it? It's ugly when you hear it for a long time, isn't it? And it's real. That's the most awful part. It's real. This isn't cosplay, baby. This is the real thing.
Mr. President, last night you were a little bit cryptic at a dinner with military personnel where you suggested that this was the calm before the storm.
Wow.
A lot of people have, inferred that perhaps this involves North Korea. How do you plan to handle the situation in North Korea?
I am hiring the X-Men woman Storm to go over to North Korea, make a big cloud, then we're gonna fly our planes into it and drop some nukes. Total cover, perfect cover. All I need is to find out where the X-Men are. I know that Captain Jean-Luc Picard is the head of the organization.
I think that's a little different, but.
He voluntarily broke his legs after his stupid nephew died.
I don't think that's.
Why in generations I want this question answered? 7 seasons of Star Trek The Next Generation, and suddenly Jean-Luc Picard cares about his stupid nephew? Nobody ever heard of Jean-Luc Picard caring about anybody besides himself and sometimes number one. So why don't we answer that question first, and then I'll get to North Korea. You tell me why Jean-Luc Picard, and what's up with Worf? How does Deanna Troi date anyone after Worf? That's my question.
I hope no one minds, but the president is going to do a little bit of his open mic set right now, just for a few minutes.
These are things that are real questions to me. Okay, Barkley, Ensign Barkley. You remind me of Barkley. You know that? You're a Barkley.
I don't know what you're talking about, but I don't have the spine to disagree.
Barkley, so true.
All right. Well, moving on from North Korea, then.
Did your family? Just out of curiosity, Sam, everyone's last name betrays what their family did in the olden times. So Mike Pence.
British pennies.
His family was in charge of British pennies. Trump. My family was in charge of always having some secret out that somehow we would land on our feet and always succeed, even though we didn't deserve it. Trump. Did your family install wood and saunas all around Finland? Sam?
Cedar.
And I want you to know, everyone told me not to do this.
I specifically meant
But I so desperately wanted it to come out of my mouth that I wasted that much time on something useless.
All right, what's your next question?
The next question I have for you is Hillary Clinton's book is out. I was wondering if you had...
Stupid Hillary.
I was wondering if you had any thoughts about the book.
Here we are in the Javits Center, where so many cheers, tears were shed, and so many cheers were Ted.
This is where her victory celebration was scheduled.
Yeah, right. But it didn't turn out that way, baby. Instead, colluding with the Russians, working with Roger Stone, who was in connection with Guccifer, and assembling a series of trolls who bought Facebook and Twitter ads and the complicity of both Twitter and Facebook to work to propagate white supremacy online, in which Twitter has not rolled back, apologized, or done anything about it, and yet profiteers off of white supremacy every day, and we all contribute to that platform by using it. I would also say that afterward, applaud for that. Applaud. And then I made sure that we just got enough votes to take it away, but we also manipulated the media. And at the same time, the media conspired to elect me president by spending $3.5 billion of free airtime covering me. So when Hillary writes a book, I go, good for you. You need the book because you don't got anything else anymore. You don't have anything else. It's so true. Poor Hillary. Get him out! Get him out! Go back under the glass ceiling. And let me tell you this. Get under it! Get under it! Get under it. I hope in that book, Hillary writes about how much she loves me, because I love her secretly.
And, I don't know if I've actually never told anybody this, but I voted for Hillary. I was sort of gauging my life up until that point, and I thought what my options were in the future and what they could be, and I stared down a vision of 4 or 8 years as your vice president and the hell that would, bring out into not only to America but on my soul, that I consider a Christian, even though I'm not. I'm clearly a duplicitous. I'm a politician first and a Christian second. And I looked at everything and I thought, listen, I can go back to be with my bunnies and my cats and everything in Indiana, and maybe I'll go start a business. Maybe coach high school basketball or something like that. And so I voted for Hillary, and obviously, everything that you said happened.
That is true.
And
it's so true. I have an admission to make too.
Okay.
I didn't vote for myself. I voted for some candidate called Checkbox Here.
Checkbox.
Must have been a third party candidate. Weird name. I thought he was a Czechoslovakian guy. It said Checkbox Here. And I put a mark next to it and then gave my voting form to Melania.
I was going to say, those are two very lucid answers.
Thank you.
I want to open up questions from the audience, but lastly, let me just ask you, what do you think your legacy will be?
My legacy will be very large divots, ass divots, in all the seats in the White House.
Right.
And when I leave office in 2028, I feel like my legacy will be most of the women will have self-deported to fairer lands where they can have more rights, and we'll all just be a bunch of men drinking milk and water and just repressing any emotion that isn't a smile. And then we'll run the country on the power of that repression.
The legacy I want to leave, Mike, besides my ass divots, which are going to be deep and plentiful, is I hope the legacy I leave, and this is going to be a fun answer, the legacy I want to leave is an awakened American public that returns to its understanding of its civic duties and responsibilities. That as a citizen of a democracy, it's not enough to simply consume things and enjoy television and eating tons of good food, which I love, but to understand that you get what you pay for. And the truth is that once I'm gone, there will be all these same problems still existing because I am simply a manifestation of those problems. I am not the source. And don't believe the notion that once we remove me, Mike's right there. Once you remove me, that somehow our world's problems are solved. This nation has a toxic problem with race, gender, LGBT rights, and the civil rights of all people. And until we reconcile with that, there will be no healing the nation. And so I hope my legacy is a reminder that it can get this bad. What happened? What happened? Where did I go? I just blanked out. Okay. Sam, I blanked out.
Right. I think
my God, I hope I didn't say that stupid cedar joke.
we'll let that one slide. We want to open up some questions.
Well, look at these. I've never seen nerds run so fast. Not since the release of Modern Warfare 3, Black Ops.
Overwatch is better.
All right.
Watch it.
We'll start with you, sir.
Okay, so my question is...
Don't blow it. Just ask the question.
Okay. Did Twitter think you were important enough to give 280 characters?
What?
Did Twitter think you were important enough to get 280 characters?
Wow, I got to tell you something. That's a very insightful question. I've never thought of it that way, but why in God's name would a company increase the number of characters when they have one of the most toxic people on it? Further reinforcing the point I made when I blacked out and don't remember. Look at this guy. This guy isn't ashamed to wear a Pornhub shirt. There you go. That's a healthy masturbator. A healthy masturbator. This guy's like, I masturbate, and I want everybody to know I could be masturbating right now.
All masturbation is unhealthy. Don't do it. Just sing Hosanna every time you feel like masturbating.
I was actually going to ask, have you seen the porno Donald Trump that they based on you from Wood Rocket?
What?
They made a porno based on you. But
you and I
a lot
live in very,
porn.
Very different worlds.
I was wondering if you've seen the porno.
I have not seen the porno. I was in one porno, a Playboy erotic adult film. F. And no, I will see it, but here's my quick. Am I the bottom or the top?
Top.
Boring. Thank you very much. You're a great perverted American.
I'm a power bottom.
That's right.
We've talked
Mike's
about
a power
that.
Bottom.
We've talked about that.
That's right. Always gets. He always drinks a glass of milk, gets to the bottom of the glass of milk, goes, I'm a power bottom. Mm-hmm. And he's got this, like, milk around his mouth.
Yep. That's what that is. Hello.
Hello.
Hi, Jeremy.
Mr. President, nice to see you. So I was hoping, you know, the fake news has been giving us their side of the story.
Yeah,
with,
this guy.
With your relationship with Rex Tillerson, so I was hoping you could maybe give us your perspective on your relationship with Rex right now.
Rex, unbelievable. First off, I'm no moron. I'm a dotard. Now, it's unbelievable. Get it right, folks. Rex, great guy. First off, when I hired him as Secretary of State, I thought it was going to be an Air Bud thing. Because I was like, Rex, I would love a dog Secretary of State. Like a dog. Like a dog. Think about that. You got a little puppy as Secretary of State. And then the puppy goes, and he goes to Iran. And the Ayatollah Khomeini, goes, I can't get mad at a little puppy. We'll get rid of our nukes. And then Rexy bounds over to North Korea. And Kim Jong-un goes, I can't, I love the puppy. And then Rex turned out to be this big, weird, sweaty, gray-haired meat monster, human Sasquatch. And I was like, great. Now I'm stuck with this guy. He's like, Mike, if like I went into a TARDIS and left and was like John Pertwee's companion, because I'm more of a Joe. I'm more of a Joe. I'm not a Tegan, certainly. And I'm definitely not. Who was the one who died who crashed into the planet? Yeah, there you go. So let me tell you this. You get
one
into a TARDIS.
In here knew
you get into a TARDIS. Time and relative dimension and space. Don't lie to me. Sonic screwdriver. So sweet. Doubles as a dildo. And then I'm in the time, and we have all these adventures, and we go see the Daleks and the Cybermen and those stupid statues. You can't look around. And then some of the lesser interesting episodes that involve usually futuristic British soldiers. And then I come back, and I go, Mike, what the hell happened to you? And it turns out to be Rex Tillerson. Great. Great
Thank
question.
You. Thank you.
Public opportunity. I just wanted to hear some comments on John McCain. What do you think about it?
He got captured. He got captured. I'm sorry. He got captured.
Sir.
You can't be a hero if you got captured. That's the way it worked. If you were playing tag and you got caught, no one's going to go, wow, that guy's great at tag. They're going to go, that guy sucks at tag.
We play tag a lot in the White House. That's why he's bringing it up. Just, you forgot he omitted it from the schedule earlier, but in between the screamings.
What a thorn in my side that guy is.
McCain?
Oh, man, McCain.
Plus, you know, he had a little work done.
Yeah, he got some surgery, got a little work done. Whoa, out of context. Tough. Very tough. I think McCain should stick to his frozen French fries. Thank you. Next.
Next. Question.
Also, if you have a brain deformity, you should just hide it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I hide my brain disorder.
Yeah.
Hi, Mr. Mike Pence. Shut up.
Hi, honey.
Hi.
What are you?
I'm a Gyarados.
What?
I'm a Pokemon. But
you're a Pokemon.
Your wife won't let me talk to you.
No. You can talk to me all you want. My wife's dead. She's dead. She just died. Oh, I forgot to announce this. Melania divorced me and then died. So I would love to make you my new first lady.
I respectfully decline.
Cool. That doesn't mean much to me. What's your question, baby?
So how do you plan on defeating North Korea?
Mark Faria?
North Korea?
Rocket
Man.
How do you plan on defeating
North Korea?
Rocket Man.
I will defeat North Korea so simply, okay? I'm going to go over there. Kim Jong-un's a nice guy. That's a good guy, okay? He's a good guy.
We talked about you not saying that.
We think alike. We're very similar. This, to me, is the classic rom-com. It's just like You've Got Mail. I'm Tom Hanks, and I run a big book company called the United States. And Kim Jong-un is Meg Ryan. And she's at this little bookshop. And, you know, Gene Stapleton's there, who played Edith in All in the Family. And Gene Stapleton's with Kim Jong-un. And she's like, oh, Kim Jong-un! And...
So it's and All in the Family and You've Got Mail put together?
Together. Right. Of course it is. Mike, you got to follow the metaphor.
I'm just trying to help.
So then they don't like each other, and then they get the letters, and they get the mail. And then they go, You've Got Mail. And then I fly over there, and I go, listen, I love you, but you got to give up your bookstore so that this large corporate conglomerate can take it over. And then in the end, they do. And she, as a woman, loses her job, and loses her independent business to be with a man and sacrifices her small business to a corporation. What a great plot. And that's what we're gonna do to North Korea.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, I'm sorry.
Let one guy, one more guy. One guy.
One more guy.
I just
had I just mean one more person. But I also prefer a guy. Mike does too.
This is going to be the last question, folks. I'm sorry.
Sorry, guys. We got to go.
I just had to correct you. You said that America's been running off white power, but for 8 years, we actually had a black president. So
I know.
Ran off black power.
No. Well, yes, it did run on black power way up at the top for 8 years. But I would argue that the latent racism of the United States didn't evaporate during those 8 years.
That's true.
Yeah, that's all. So cool. So cool.
You kind of started fake news by saying that Obama wasn't born in this country.
No. Obama was also born on Krypton. He landed in Kenya, where a white middle-class family raised him. And we know the story from there.
Miss him.
Thank you.
I miss him.
I miss him too. That's why I keep blaming him for stuff, even though he's no longer president.
Mr.
President? I also voted for Obama. I should. Just a bunch of times. For different things.
I voted in the Iraqi election in 2004.
Mr. President, Mr. Vice President, thank you so much for sharing with us today.
Of course.
Oh, wonderful. Sam Seder, everybody. A liar, a cheat, a manipulator of the truth. But for once, you did a good job.
I'm not really sure I wanted to hear that from you.
So wonderful. Thank you, everybody.
Is there anything else?
Are we all leaving? Bye. Bye.